the coffee.
Just for the purpose of just seeing it as a sketch, you can always open up the road just a little bit for me, so you can go to the darker exposure. It's not really a stop, it's to have a coffee. It's a stop to have a coffee and do some work, because we're going to just have a look at some of the things we shot already, just to have a look at what we've done. And when you do this and you put it together, it just gives you a rough idea of what you've done, what's, you know, what you've achieved in the previous 1, 2, 3 hours, and to make sure that I'm on track here. A technician allows me to really look into the imagery, and bit by bit I can really think about what I'm doing here without me having to take part of my brain and work out the technical side of that. So next, we're going to go up to a place called the Fairy Glen. It's a strange little pocket. It's almost like, it almost looks like a burial ground or something. Stuart, it's Albert here. Could you bring up a couple of sparklers? Don't forget the matches. What I'm looking for is just some of the trees here that grow next to or into the walls, and the kind of place that fairies hide, you know? So I'm just going to run a test here with some sparklers I got and maybe some Roman candles, and see if we can work some of that sparkle into the shots here. Be creative. Two macho guys with sparklers, there we go. Hold on, wait 1 second, that was not good, Julia, hold on. And coming in now, okay. You should have that, Julia, right? And there it is, good. More energy, Stuart. Don't wimp out on me. There we go. Look at these two fairies working with the lights here. Okay, hold on. Now, just...
So you don't have any kind of qualms about like manipulating nature to get the shot, do you?
Not at all. I mean, you know, when a painter, if Moni's painting his lily pond, guess what? Those colours aren't exactly what was in the lily pond. So, I mean, it's you're doing impressions of things. You're creating images. You think it's going to go up?
Up and in
there. What we're just adding on top here is a little bit of, we hope, mystery, a little bit of suggesting some magic here, which fireworks are. Basically, when you do something like this, it's all experimentation. Sometimes shots like this are not so easy. And in this case here, the firework is very, very bright. And the tree is quite dark.
All right, wait till it comes in. Oh, there you go, hit it. Hit one more. Easy on the camera.
Let's shoot a little bit to your left.
good.
All right, let's just, we can drop the camera right here. I'm sure there are times in the year where there's some mist coming through here, but I'm not really able to sit here for 365 days until that mist drifts through exactly where I want it.
Okay. Set up, good.
And what's the set of focus to?
All right, well, that's definitely worth doing, I think. It needs a little bit more space on the left-hand side. It'll take me a few minutes just to do the technical side. Creatively, I think it's fine.
Okay, here it comes.
Okay.
Cut! Of course, dude. Just aged 50 years.
Oh, no, he comes out of the mist.
That's about 20 packs of cigarettes you had there.
Do you ever think, what am I doing here in bad weather conditions, or do you always have a will to work still?
I never think, what am I doing here? I think I'm lucky to be here. So, you know, as long as you have a camera in your hand or on a tripod in front of you, there's never a problem. I don't care how cold it is, how hot it is. Once a camera's in my hand, you forget everything. You don't even notice anything. You don't notice rain. You don't notice a cold. Basically, you just keep going. When you have a camera in your hand, you don't really, as a photographer, you're not really, you don't notice anything, actually. Yeah, I can easily work 10 hours. I don't even need to eat anything. So you can just keep going. As long as you have a camera. If you take away the camera, then suddenly you feel hungry, tired, thirsty, whatever, you know. But with a camera, that takes...
And are you going to stop for lunch today, though?
Well, we had coffee. Actually looking for some rain, so I get some rain on the windshield of the car. Almost an impressionistic shot of what you're looking at. You're not just looking for like one picture, you're trying to integrate the pictures into one story. So some photographers just go out and shoot a lot of shots. Other photographers might be thinking more of a storyline. I think creativity is kind of an interesting thing. Lots of time people say, well, where did that idea come from? And it kind of pops in from a secret place in your brain, I think. It's quite good here. It's quite desolate here. So, I'm going to have them just put some water on the... Keith?
Go for Keith.
You have a spritzer?
There, coming in, one sec.
Just give you a basic frame here.
Are you okay. Moving the camera?
Not yet.
Like there's motion blur.
Okay. There will be. Check this out. It just takes me a couple of exposures to find this, so hold on.
The exposure is beautiful right now.
Right, that's a better shot. And what's nice on Sky are these track roads that are very, very... They're not bad roads, but they're pretty rough at the same time. And... I just find them a little bit interesting, a little bit mysterious. How's that?
That's great. Really good.
Today was excellent for me. You know, in the end, a good day for me is if I get one shot that I think is quite good. But today, I have three shots that are contenders, so it's a really good day for me today.
I've had a magical time on this island, but I'm looking forward to getting back to New York to really work on these pictures. Thank you.